Hello and welcome to a new webinar episode. My name is Tom Wittig, and our topic today is about where do I come from? As always, it's about information and systemic insights in the context of ancestry research, genealogy, family research. So today, what I have planned for the kickoff of the webinar today is to talk about the question again, where do we come from, and why that is an important question. And I also want to show an example and come back to some of the comments that were submitted. And also I have a search tip and trick for you for a Google search, which I will share later on, which is also related to the topic today. So the question, where do I come from? Where do we come from? Typically arises at some point in people's life. Usually a little bit later, at a later stage in the life, where you ask yourself, okay, why are we here? Where did the family come from? Where were the parents from? Where did the grandparents and the ancestors live? And as we are exploring this question, many people find some interesting surprises about their heritage and where they come from. And once you start on this quest for more information and getting more insights, a lot more branches are actually opening up, and then you find a lot more information. But usually when you follow a certain trace and you arrive at that point where you find the insights about the family, that's usually a very healing fundamental movement for a lot of people. So I think it's not really about curiosity, but it's kind of an inner motion that is bringing people to explore this question. And oftentimes I hear in seminars and also in webinars or individual consultations, who is my mother? Who is my father? Who are my parents? Because some people did not meet their parents. So either they deceased, they passed away in an early age, or also what is very common, what was also very common in the past century, past decades, is that people were given away as a child to other families or to institutions, for example. And then at a certain age, even more for these fellow people, it's important to find out where they come from and learn more about the history of the parents and grandparents. Well, our approach that we talked about in the previous webinars and some of the live seminars is that we're working between the pure rational side, the information gathering side, and also what I would call the more the spirit-minded side. So here we are looking for systemic insights. And then we're interested in what are the fundamental movements in the family? What are the hidden dynamics? And also we find a lot of topics that sometimes people really do not talk about or did not talk about in the past. And we are surprised, but sooner or later they're surfacing. And then it's an interesting motion, also an interesting movement for people to reconcile that also with their present life, because always the question is, what does it mean for my present life, for the here and now, of course. But both areas are two sides of the same coin, so to speak. So they are basically inspiring each other and feeding each other. So the more information I have, the further I can also go with exploring in the context of systemic family or ancestry constellations, for example, what is happening, what is the movement in the family. And that also sometimes raises more questions or gives more meaning and more insights to the factual research about family records and so on. So that brings me to the next topic. On the information side, what people typically do is the first focus point is, of course, the family record. So you look into old family albums, photo albums, family records where people came from, or immigration records for a lot of people actually in the United States, where there were big waves of migration. People were coming in big numbers. And we are lucky today that we have a wealth of information and we can also use the search engine. I'll come back to that later on when I talk a little bit about one trick that I wanted to share with you. But also genealogy has come up as a topic more and more for a lot of people. And for a lot of people, it's also important to understand when you come from a family background where people were moving from one place to another, from one continent to another, it's also important to understand where did they come from? Why did they talk about their home in a certain way? And then once you go there, you have a better understanding. And also very popular right now is the DNA analysis, DNA research, where you can find out you know, where your lineage is basically coming from and what's basically population your ancestors belong to. So a very interesting moment in time, and I think we will hear more and more about that. Now, again, on the systemic side of the house, there are always, in many family trees, there are white spots. I talked about that in an earlier session, the white spot on the family tree. And sometimes these are areas where we cannot really figure out what was happening there and who was sometimes excluded. And when somebody is excluded from the family system, not talked about or rejected or pushed out of the family system for a certain reason, it typically has a systemic effect on everybody else in the family system. That's important to understand, and that's what we see and discover again and again in family situations. There have been there's been done a lot of work about this in the early days with Bert Hellinger, for example, and now people coming more and more to the seminars to find out, okay, what was going on in the family, and why is it relevant for the here and now, for my present life, for example. But also there's a form of meditation we can use to get more in tune with this kind of work. And of course, I always suggest physical journeys to the birthplaces. Very important movement to really get in touch and get a better sense and feeling in the true meaning that you feel about what were the seasons like in the place where your ancestors come from. So very, very important movement there. Now, when we talk about the family ancestors and the constellation, we of course have to talk about the parents and grandparents, the lineage of all the mothers and fathers. And one thing that I heard, for example, from a participant here was, I don't have parents, but I want to know more about where I come from. I have only an old photograph of my mother. Now, of course, I had to smile because everybody has parents because you're coming from mother and father, of course. Now, I guess what was meant here is that the participant did not meet the parents in person. And so I never got to meet them. And so we did an exercise in this particular constellation, as we do sometimes for getting a higher awareness about a certain topic. And so here we put all the mothers and all the fathers in a row, and the client was facing them and also standing there with all the parents and grandparents behind her. And so that is a very important experience, a very fundamental, very moving experience for a lot of people. Not only this client here, but also the people who are standing in this lineage, in this row of all the fathers, the grandfathers, and the great-great-grandfathers of the person. It's an interesting experience to make in a constellation seminar. Again, it's an exercise. When we work with systemic constellation in the traditional way, or also in the new way of working with family constellation as it's developed and pioneered from Bert and Sophie Hellinger, for example, we discover more and more dynamics and also entanglements in the family system. But that's a good way to do, and you can actually try that and practice that. But if you have a real topic about an ancestry topic, I would suggest that you always work with an experienced constellation leader, constellation facilitator. And here I had another great feedback. So thank you for the tips and tricks with search engines. We had already some great discoveries of records and images. And that brought me to another point, because recently I published a small ebook. It's available on the website. I think right now it's only available in German, but I'm going to translate that in English as well. It's no problem. And I discovered something that I forgot to mention, because with Google, it's also possible to search with pictures, not only for pictures. So you're looking for pictures or images of people. But if you, for example, have like this client here, you have only an image, a picture of a person, you can actually use Google to help you find more information related to that image or picture. So the address that you go to is images.google.com. Normally you go to google.com, but here you have images.google.com. And it looks like Google, but with the only difference that there's here this little icon that you can see. It's the camera icon. Once you click on that, you get a menu where you can upload a photograph or an image, for example, or you can enter a web link, a URL. And that actually brings up in a window. So the example that I walked through in the ebook, I used Albert Einstein as an example, because a lot of people know him, not personally, but have heard about him, and they can relate to his story, and he's pretty famous, I guess. And so if you take the picture of Albert Einstein, then Google is fairly efficient and very quickly finds a ton of images and information. But if you scroll down on the page, what you find is that Google also brings up pages with which have a similarity, where Google finds similar pictures, and then they bring the link to the page. So I thought that's another great tip, and it makes life easier to find the people that are missing, to find the information that you're looking for. So with that trick, I hope you have also some good luck and find more information. So before I go into the live Q&A, I would like to pick up on some further comments and questions that were submitted up front. So there was one question here. My great-grandfather was a soldier officer in the war. I want to know more about him, but I'm a little bit scared about what I might find. What should I do? Now, of course, this is a big topic also in a lot of families, where the grandfathers or mothers or grandmothers, for example, have served in the military during war times. And as we know, the times of war are not pretty. So that's another part of our reality. So I would always suggest to work on such important topics with an experienced facilitator in a family constellation, and then see what surfaces. And I always say, okay, the question is always, what does it mean for the here and now? And sometimes when we see what was happening during the war, it's also important to see above and beyond, and to see the bigger picture, what was happening, and also what is the context in the here and now. There's nothing that we can change in the past, but it has a certain relevance for our here and now. And what I see in many of the constellations is that it is resonating into the present family. Okay, another comment was here. Finally, we visited the birthplace of my parents and grandparents, a truly moving experience, and I really felt like it came full circle. While in the spirit of touching circles, the name for the series about family constellation in the context of genealogy and ancestry, I'm happy that somebody made the journey, and I hope to hear more from you, and please share your insights in the Facebook group. So that brings me to the other topic. You can always send a question or a suggestion up front. There's a new Facebook group that you can use. There's actually a Facebook page and a group. So the group you find by going to Facebook/group/touching circles, and there's a place where you can discuss, share, ask questions about this theme and this topic. Okay, And so I hope that you will stay in touch. Here are the social properties. So you just search for Constellateur or go to the website. So there you have also all the web links and all the information. Well, having said that, I want to take now a few questions live and see what came up here in the live webinar. And as always, the questions are published. The webinar topics are published in advance. So if you want to join one of the future webinars, you're very welcome, of course.